joining in at Urban TV. Yes, we are back at it again. You are watching Saloon Talk. It's a beautiful Wednesday morning. We're here in Kasanga at Sammy Baba. It's a beautiful unisex saloon for both men and women. So guys, if you know you want to have your hairstyle like me, if you know you want to look dope like me, so guys, better come down to the Sammy Baba here right in Kasanga opposite Beverly Hills. They're gonna be working on you. I'm your girl Sobriya Hills, aka Wild and Free, and of course I'm gonna be here every Sunday bringing you hot topics with your celebrity guests, with your influential guests. In the building, I'm joining by two beautiful ladies. They're gonna introduce themselves. One has experience in the topic that we're gonna talk about, and one does not, but she's also gonna tell us her opinion. So the question of today is, if you're a star and you get pregnant, does it spoil your career or it doesn't change anything?
Hi, what's up, it's your girl, aka Mama Pesa. I'm a media personality, I'm an actress, I'm a beauty therapist, and I am a mother. Today I'm hosted on Saloon Talk, and of course we're gonna be discussing about pregnancy. All I can say is pregnancy is a blessing. It is not a curse. I totally disagree with everyone here, and I wanna teach people out there that giving birth is not the end of it all. Stay tuned, it is Saloon Talk.
Hi. My name is Batamliza Lisa Amanda, and today I've been on Saloon Talk. I love arguing, I love discussing different issues, I love giving my opinions about things. And end of the day, in my opinion, I don't feel like I'm ready to get pregnant, because at this point in life, I'm just trying to figure out my life. I'm trying to work on myself, and I'm trying to get to where I want to be in life. So the whole thing of getting pregnant and get to that point where I'm gonna have kids and make a family, no, not any sooner.
So, Lynette, before we go into like any more conversation, any deep jazz, if you first tell me, I wanted to ask, how did you get the courage? Like, where did you get the courage from to actually go through with the pregnancy? Because it's not easy for like a person like you, a star like you, more so when you've been like, when you've reached in your peak of your career, it's not easy for someone to come out nagamba kale kamfu no mwana, let me have this child. Where did you get the courage from?
First of all, I want to remind you that pregnancy is not a curse, it's a blessing. When you ask me where I got the courage, it is like asking me this. You're trying to say, is pregnancy a curse? Because ever since I got pregnant, and ever since I felt, you know, it has been a new thing to me. Trust me, it has always been blessings after blessings. The respect I've earned as a mother, the love from the people, because we've seen a number pregnant and still making it in life. Back then, women didn't have careers, but now we do. Gone are the days where women used to just sit home and give birth. The question should be, how are you ready? How are you prepared after birth? That's the main question here. But for the courage, they need courage, because you can't give birth and continue with your career.
Okay, the main question that has been like in everybody's mind, everybody's lips, is that if for a star like you, now you, Lynette, you're a big brand, you are a star, you're gonna reach different horizons. Very many people are like, oh, Lynette, why would she be pregnant? She has just become a star. Like, for you, do you think that being pregnant is gonna bring down your career, or it's actually gonna help you more on your career?
The First Lady of Uganda is a mother, for your information. Not only Uganda, we've seen a number of big women. Gaba mama, like, they are mothers. A lot of women have met the ministers, like, I cannot break all of them down. Ministers are mothers. Like I told you earlier, back then, it is so different. Back then, women used not to do that. They used to get afraid. It is the same mentality you are having, or people are having lately. I believe we should change that mentality and style up, get back to the normal us. You can go give birth, come back and do your career. There's no job that would fire you because you got pregnant. Is it there?
No, actually, for more, I think they give you more respect. The fact that you're pregnant, they give you more care, more love, more attention. We know that you're a first-time mom. This is going to be your first-time pregnancy. It's going to be for first time for everything. Aren't you scared?
Why would I be scared? First of all, you have to be financially stable, which I am. I'm financially stable to take care of my child. So what would make me get scared? Like, what would I be scared? Of course, I did not get pregnant alone. The baby daddy has to be in the picture.
Okay. So, Lynette, you're about to give birth, and the baby is coming soon. Obviously, you're going to take a break off work, because you have to, like, heal. You have to attend to your to your baby, like the first new months are always the most tricky. So how are you going to cope up with all that? Are you like ready for that? Are you ready for the late nights, the waking up at night, the feeding, the pain, the back pain? Because I've talked to several mothers and they always say, ha, moso mwana soka bana, that kid always hurts your mwana waruma, what?
It drives me back to the financially stable thing I told you. If you have people around you, if you have family, even if you don't have family, by the way, with you to help you, these things are easy. We were born by mother. We were raised and born by strong.
So, okay, let me ask Lisa, because now I want to know. I want to know for a person who hasn't given birth before or even planning. Lisa, how are you doing?
I'm okay. How are you doing?
So I'm asking this for a person who hasn't given birth before, and I know you're not even planning on giving birth anytime soon. Very many people have this concept of, when I'm young, my career is gonna be down. I'm not gonna reach horizons that I was supposed to reach because I'm going to be like spending time with my baby, and I don't have like everything is taken off by your baby. So you're a person who is working, you're a beautiful lady in Kampala or Kola, you have your job, you have money, you can support yourself. Like for you, like what's your take on this whole thing? Can it spoil your career or it does not?
Well, personally, I believe like giving birth is like a step in life. It's not something that you're going to wake up in the morning and then you go maybe in the shop and buy a cloth. Because at the end of the day, you may get tired of the cloth and maybe throw it away or just keep it or something like that. This is like a step that you take in life. That is a step that you, it's not something like, it's something you just have to sit and think about before going into. You get like, it's really a big step in life. It's like going to, let me say I've been working in this position, I get tired of it, and then I feel like I want to go to the next place. It's something like that. So by the time I wake up and I feel like I want to be a mother, I feel like I need to be at that stage in life where I feel like I am grown enough. Okay, I'm grown, yeah, but I'm already at the age where I'm grown, but I don't feel like I'm really at that age where I'm going to become a mother. Yeah, exactly. So if I'm waking up one morning and I'm deciding to have a baby, like I'm getting pregnant, it is a step in life and it is going to affect me. I'm not going to stay in the same position that I'm in. If I've been working, let me say, if I've been working 6 days a week, it is definitely going to affect me. I'm not going to be the same way, because when you have a kid, when you're deciding to have a baby, yes, exactly, they're going to affect whatever you're doing in your life. So this is like leaving the stage you're on at that moment, going to the next stage. So I feel like it's going to affect me. So at this point in life where I am right now, I feel like I'm not really ready to go.
If we're to understand, most of the cases, the first pregnancy is always unplanned. In most cases, most of for young girls, like in most cases, like bigger cases, some obviously plan for them because they meet the person who they've been looking for a very long time and they're like, okay, fine, let me settle. But in most cases, the first pregnancies of girls or of ladies, of people, they come unexpectedly. Like, no, I'm pregnant. So let me ask you a question. If yes, Lisa, you're working, like you've said, you don't have time for all that. If at all you find yourself and you go and you happen to check and then you are like, oh my God, now it's a plus. Okay, now I'm going to be a mother. Like, and you have no choice, but you have to raise because that's the option. You know, like we don't believe in the things of removing because people, we are godly people. We do not think of that. But anyway, if it's your choice, it's your choice. Anyway, so if I told you to find out that you're pregnant right now, Lisa, what would be your like your first off your head? What would be your first action?
Oh well, for starters, I'll be super scared because for the fact that you know about the fact that you're not prepared for it, it is something that has just come up. But well, we are women, and if you're grown at any moment, you can expect to have a kid as long as you're a woman and you menstruate and all that. So I would first be scared, but then at the end of the day, if it has come about, I feel like, okay, well, that is God's making. If it has come about and I'm pregnant, well, this is what I talked about. This is a turning point in my life. If I've been thinking this certain way, it definitely is going to change at that particular moment. Because you think about, okay, I don't feel like abortion is it's an option to me. I feel like if I'm getting pregnant right now, even if I'm ready for it, I can't really abort. I don't think of something like that. So I just think of the fact that it is a turning point in my life that I've really come to face, even though I'm not ready for it. So this is when I start to change my thinking. and then this is when I'm going to start thinking about things, because at the end of the day you feel like, okay, yes, I'm becoming a mother. I'm not ready for this, but well, it has come my way, so.
Would you, if you decide to actually have it, would you want to involve the baby daddy, or would you be like, I'm a hardworking woman, come, let me take care of my child? You know, most people have that mentality these days.
Well, about the question, of course, at the end of the day, you don't get pregnant alone. It has to be a man, you know, you can't have a kid alone, so a man has to be involved. But then, it happens in different cases. You might find, because as you said, sometimes it comes as a mistake, as you said, it has come about that I'm not ready for it. It may come to a point where it feels like the man is not ready to support you. This is when you have to be there for yourself. Okay, well, if the man is there, that is well and good, because everyone would love to have kids with that man. But if it doesn't come out that way, you have to stand in it. Yes, and you have to stand in it and
actually, be there for yourself. Actually, on the question of first pregnancy, let me first come back to you, Lynette. Because, like, we all know this is your first pregnancy. First time pregnancy, obviously there is that mixed feeling, there is, okay, I want to keep it, okay, I want to do this. The first time you actually found out you're pregnant, what was running in your mind?
I'm in a relationship with someone. Oh, I'm in a happy relationship, I might say.
Oh, wow.
Yes, there is nothing like I got pregnant by mistake. How? You're not a non-living thing.
There are these girls, by the way. There are these girls above Vion. They are young. Yeah, they are in the middle of their career. Like, they have a jet reach, but they are the captaincy. And then they're like, oh my God, how is the community going to see me? How is this? And then, like, they are so taken up by the words of the people.
Exactly. I have been through that. I have first.
Yeah, by the way, I was about to come even to that. First, tell us, because that was a very timing moment for you. I can try to relate. It's very hard, more so for pregnant women. They're always having emotions, mixed feelings, having this, and now someone attacking you and attacking your baby. That is something that. So how did you cope up with all that?
Despite the negativity in the society, the fact that I was attacked by a fellow media personality, it hit me so hard. I didn't watch the show personally. It was on a certain TV station. I was out with my man, and they called us. My friend called me, like, do you know this and this and this? This talking about, this guy is talking about your pregnancy. They sent me the video. The first thing, as a media personality, I was so much used to negativity. We are taught how to handle negativity.
And the fact that she's also, like, the person is also a personality, you would expect the person to actually, like, be on your side and actually value your feelings. Because being a woman, actually, no matter what, whether it was a man or a woman, if you are a lady and your fellow lady is going through something that you also know you go through it one day, one time, then why be such a very bad person?
This was actually done twice. The first interview was a man. The first thing that came into my mind was, I didn't even sleep that night. The first thing that came into my mind was to go for abortion. To see if it would make him happy, because he disrespected me in a way of if you got pregnant, what taina cha tugamba. He said a lot that I don't even want to say. I don't even want to hear those words again. In my heart, I was like, let me make an appointment with a guy now to go and remove this thing to see if he'll be happy. If I'm useless to the society right now, then. But then at night I'm like, hell no. Who is he?
Who is he to make me do?
Is he even worth it? He was born and raised by a mother. He was also born the same way I'm gonna give.
Actually,
to my child.
I think the question we should be asking is such men who bring up such funny questions. Oh, mumu zauka makati aha. If your mom decided also to remove you, singa kati tuino mutu akwa TV. Anyway, before we jump into that, our sponsors are calling us. Let us first go to a break. Guys, don't forget you're still watching Saloon Talk. You are watching Urban TV. Thank you for tuning in. We shall be right back with more.